Welcome everyone, I'm Laura Shu. In this video, I'll show you how to move your photos to another hard drive. You could also use this lesson for moving photos somewhere else on the same hard drive. Note that if you haven't imported the photos into Lightroom that you want to move, then there's no need to watch this video. Instead, use Mac Finder or Windows File Explorer to move those photos and then import them into Lightroom. Watch my video on importing photos already on your hard drive or already on your computer. Now, there's another video in this Lightroom Fundamentals and Beyond series called Reorganizing Files and Folders. In that video, I provide comprehensive instructions on how to use Lightroom's Folders panel to move folders, rename folders, move photos from one folder to another, etc. With those techniques, you just drag and drop here in the Folders panel. That not only moves folders and files here in Lightroom, but it moves them on your hard drive, so you are cleaning up or reorganizing your hard drive in the process. In the other video, I explained that using Lightroom's Folders panel means Lightroom never becomes confused. You never end up with question marks on folders, because Lightroom can see you do those moves. In this video, I'm going to use a different technique. We're going to go out to Windows Explorer or the Mac Finder and move folders of photos out there, and then we'll come back to Lightroom and we'll resolve all of the question marks or confusion that we've created for Lightroom. Because we're giving up the convenience of doing it here and we're creating question mark issues, I reserve this technique that I'll cover for moving very large numbers of photos, an entire year of photos, or all of your photos. Doing it outside of Lightroom does have a couple advantages. First, the move tends to be quicker. Lightroom doesn't move files as fast. Second, at least theoretically, it can be safer because instead of moving the files, you can copy them and then verify that in the copy, you have exactly the same number of files and the same amount of information as you did in the original source. And then once you're sure, you can delete the originals. So copying and then deleting is safer than moving. With a copy, if your system crashes in the middle, you may have a defective copy, but you can go back to your originals. With a move, there's that very small chance that you could lose files. Regardless of what method you choose to move your files, it's always a good idea to have a hard drive backup before you begin, so that if anything goes wrong, you've got a way to get back to where you were before the issue occurred. Now, right now my Folders panel doesn't show my folder hierarchy. It shows all of the folders that I imported, but it doesn't, for example, show what folder my Oregon Coast folder resides in. Let's say I go outside of Lightroom and I move all of these folders elsewhere. I would have to come back into Lightroom and resolve question marks on each of these folders individually. That could be really painful if you have dozens and dozens of folders. So we want to make sure that the folder structure is revealed here. If yours looks like mine right now, right-click on one of the folders that doesn't show what folder it resides in and choose Show Parent Folder. If you don't have this option, then the parent of the one you right-clicked on already shows. So now I can see that this Trees folder resides in my 2015 folder. Perfect. Now I'll right-click on 2015 and I'll show its parent. That resides in Photos Go Here. I'll go one more level. I'll right-click on Photos Go Here, Show Parent Folder, and that resides in Pictures. Now, if I go outside of Lightroom and I move all of the 2015 folders, when I come back, I'll be able to resolve the question mark on 2015, and it will automatically resolve the ones on all of these other folders. Now, I just realized that my folder counts probably don't look like yours. I have 0 photos sitting straight in 2015, but if you add up how many are in its subfolders, it should be much higher than 0. So I'm going to change a setting here back to the default. I'll go to Library and I'll choose Show Photos in Subfolders. Now mine shows what you would expect. I have 70 photos in 2015, including what's in the subfolders. Now you could use this process that I'll show you for an individual year, for your Master Images folder, for your entire Pictures folder. That's up to you. But I'll move my 2015 folder. So I'll go out to Mac Finder or Windows Explorer, and I'll start out here by selecting the drive that I'm going to copy the photos to. I've already set up a photo library folder. In the last video, I moved my Lightroom catalog to here. Now I'll right-click and create a new folder, and I'll call this Photos Go Here. I like this name for my Master Images folder, the idea for which I got from David Marks, because it makes it very clear where I'm supposed to put my photos. Now I'm going to get a second Finder window or Windows Explorer window. On a Mac, I'll go to File, New Finder Window. On a PC in Windows Explorer, you would go to File, Open New Window. And I'll size this so that I can see both on my screen here. And I'll go to where the folder I want to move or copy is. This one's in my Pictures folder, in my Photos Go Here folder, and it's this 2015 folder. I'll click and drag it up into Photos Go Here on the external drive. Now, because I'm dragging from one hard drive to another, that's automatically copying that folder. If you're dragging from one location on a drive to another location on the same drive, then on a Mac, you'll want to hold down the Alt key as you drag so that you see the plus, so that you're copying. And on a PC, you would hold down the Control key to copy to a new location on the same drive. Next, because in real life I'd be moving thousands of photos, and because I'm planning to delete the original versions, I want to next check to make sure that I do have a complete copy, that it was completely successful. So on the external drive, I'll right-click on the folder, and on a Mac, I'll choose Get Info. On a PC, I would choose Properties, and it tells me right here the size in bytes and how many items or files there are. Now, for the internal drive version, I'll do the same thing. Right-click, Get Info or Properties. So I have exactly the same number of bytes, exactly the same number of items. So I'm in good shape. The copy worked perfectly. Now that I'm convinced that that's the case, I would then delete the version on my internal hard drive. Right-click, move to trash, move to the recycle bin, etc. This is a little bit of a sidetrack, but I'll mention that if you're on Windows, it can be a good idea to set a permanent drive letter for the hard drive that you've just moved your photos to, if you haven't already. Otherwise, after you tell Lightroom to look to your F drive for your photos, for example, as we're going to do in a minute, if you then plug in other devices before this photo drive and the drive letter for it changes to G, then Lightroom's going to be confused, and you'll end up with question marks on folders that you have to resolve. You can tell Windows to always use the same drive letter for this hard drive. I recommend X, Y, or Z. This is a good time to do it because Lightroom doesn't know about this drive yet, so it won't get confused. Now, I'm not going to give you the instructions on how to do this because Microsoft could change them tomorrow. But Google Set Permanent Drive Letter Windows 10, or whatever version you have. It usually involves using the disk management feature. Then come back to this video. Now back to our task. Now I'm going to come back to Lightroom. Sure enough, on the folder that I deleted, I've got question marks. Not to worry, we'll just tell Lightroom where the photos now are. I'll right-click on the 2015 folder and choose Find Missing Folder. Now, Lightroom is not going to go find the folder Find missing folder means you go find the missing folder. So out here, you'll navigate to where you moved it to. Go to my photos drive, photo library, photos go here, select 2015. That's the one I right-clicked on to find the missing folder, and then I'll click on choose. Now it seems like the folder disappeared. I don't see 2015, but it's not in my pictures folder anymore. It's on this other hard drive. I see all of my folders, and they don't have question marks. Now this one has a question mark, but it had a question mark before I even started on this process. That's another issue entirely. Now on this drive, I'd like to reveal what 2015 resides in. So I'll right-click on that, show parent folder. I can see photos go here. And if I want to, I could right-click on that to show my photo library folder as well. But this gives me enough to be able to work with these files now. Now, if after you copied your folder to another drive, you didn't delete the original version, then you don't have question marks like I did. In that case, since Lightroom is still looking at the copy on the original drive, you'll right-click on that folder and you won't see Find Missing Folder because Lightroom doesn't think it's missing. Instead, you'll choose Update Folder Location. You'll navigate to wherever you copied the folder to, go in and select it, then click on Choose. I'll go ahead and cancel. Then you'll see Lightroom displaying it in the new location. I took a break from the video recording, and when I returned, Lightroom had decided that my external photos hard drive belongs after my internal drive. That makes more sense alphabetically anyway. Now that my external hard drive is showing here, I can use the Folders panel to do smaller moves. Maybe as I'm traveling, I store photos that I capture on the road on my internal drive, and then when I get home, I drag them down to my external. Watch my video on reorganizing files and folders for a complete lesson on what you can do here with the Folders panel. Remember, as I mentioned in my organizing and backing up video, if your main computer is a laptop, and if you build smart previews for photos that are on external drives, you can edit your photos even when your external drive isn't plugged in. Watch my video on smart previews for all about that topic. This concludes the lesson on moving your photos to a new hard drive.